Get ready to match the stars. Clifton Davis, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Rona Barrett, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Yes. Now, wait a minute.
Is there a carnival in town?
No, there is not a carnival in town.
Thank you.
You know why I'm wearing this? Because some kind fan sent it to me. I think.
Jerry Mahoney.
Jerry Mahoney, yes.
Well, that's beautiful. Is that hand embroidered?
It's all hand done.
Well,
yes.
Look at me, sweetheart, because I can't see
What's
it.
What's wrong? Did you get hurt?
I got.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
That's the
night is young. Listen, we're all very happy to see all of you. No, I just our
yes.
regulars, Brett,
yeah.
Charles,
uh-huh.
and Richard,
yes.
and Clifton from
Davis.
That's My Mama. And
there's a good butterfly beat. Going for your throat.
There's a butterfly going for my throat,
yeah,
and we're happy.
A few bars.
From Mary Tyler Moore and this lady who does specials, and now let's say hello to Brian Flanagan and Barbara Benner. How are you?
Fine,
good. Now, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you, okay? Let's begin with Barbara, and she'll tell us the story of her life, okay?
I am a flight attendant.
Yes.
And it's fantastic because I really enjoy traveling, and I enjoy people.
Uh-huh.
And I'm going to be getting into scuba diving, and I enjoy life.
Okay, Barbara, I hope you have a good time here. Now, let's find out who Brian Flanagan is.
Yes, I'm a mixologist in the California area.
A what?
I'm a mixologist. Commonly known as the friendly bartender.
Oh, a mixologist. A mixologist. Yeah, he did look familiar to you, didn't he, Brad? Yes?
Grew up in Tacoma, Washington for the 21 years of my life, then spent the last 15 in Santa Barbara. However, now I'm residing in the Paramount area.
In the Paramount area?
Yes.
Anything you say, Brian, is okay with me. May I remind both of you that you're going to be trying to match as many of our celebrities as possible, and the winner will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which you can have a payoff of over $10,000. Are you ready? Right. Okay. Barbara, you want A or B here?
I want B.
You want B?
Mm-hmm.
Barbara Benner wants B, and here it is. Confucius say, old man who marry young girl better take brank on honeymoon. Old man who marry young girl better take brank on honeymoon.
Oh, I got it.
You understand me?
See.
Don't say nothing yet. Don't say until I say you say. You ready, fat lady?
Fat lady? Fat lady? You'd call the fat lady fat?
Okay, everybody ready over here. Let's go over to Barbara Benner. Confucius say, Barbara, old man who marry young girl better take brank on honeymoon.
Young man.
Young man on honeymoon. Uh-huh. So... Yes, sir.
I wouldn't mind being there.
That's enough of that. Now, just to hold a card up, show and tell time there.
Confucius say.
Yes?
Old man who marry young girl.
Yes?
Better take doctor on honeymoon.
Doctor!
Better take doctor.
You very good.
Oh, thank you.
You funny people, very funny.
Oh, we go for the race.
What do you say?
I'm not at liberty to divulge who Jack Klugman took on his honeymoon with us. It was an extra fella.
An extra fella. And there's one for Barbara, one young man, Charles.
I said, vitamin, and don't do accent as good as my friend over
I
there.
Said, he said, vitamin. All right, Rona Barrett, what do you say here?
Confucius say we'll take a blanket to keep yourself warm.
A blanket? That would help. I don't know how, but I guess it would help.
I don't have to explain to you
how
it could help.
No, I don't want you to explain it to me.
Offended two groups.
Yes, indeed.
Japanese and the woolen industry.
Confucius say old man who marry young girl better take Brank on honeymoon. What do you say?
Top of the morning.
Top of the morning, you say?
It's not a good accent, but it's a friendly thought.
Thank you very much.
I say, man who te vai all.
Yes.
Go with young, go on honeymoon.
Yes.
Must take pacemaker with him.
Pacemaker.
From the film.
From the film called?
To Have Heart.
You've got to have heart, yes. Honeymoon don't work if you don't have a heart, is that right?
You've got to have a lot more than heart on a honeymoon.
Now, let's stop right here and go to Southern Belle on the end of the row there.
Oh, from Southern China, should only take pacemaker if going to step out on wife. Ah, no, should take Flend with him.
Take Flend. That's a one man. Okay. So, Brian, she scored two. Celebrity matches with her. Now let's see how you do with your first round question there. Here it is. Lawrence Welk said...
Yes?
A one, a two.
Who are the confusions now?
He said, wonderful, wonderful. Tonight on the show we have King Kong. Mr. Kong will blank the Lennon sisters.
Oh, well. The ratings should be pretty good on that.
That's what he said, Brian. Wonderful, wonderful. Tonight on the show we have King Kong. Mr. Kong will blank the Lennon sisters. All right. It's not easy.
No. Once you get that fur coat off him.
Yes. That's very good.
He will.
You're still thinking.
Oh, yeah.
See, it's King Kong.
King Kong. Yes, I remember him
and
well.
And you remember the Lennon sisters.
Well, not really.
Well, put something on the card. Okay. Because
how many of them were there? Or how many were there?
There were three.
Two, King and Kong.
No. You touched the calf of my leg.
Well, I'm a lover, didn't you know?
Oh, yeah.
That's a terrific.
All right, I love it. All right, these two ladies are ready down
here. I'm ready.
And Richard's ready, and the Clifton is ready now.
Wait a minute, I'm almost ready. I have to beat Charles or I'll kill myself.
What's that? Everything's okay. Everything's okay.
Perfect.
Come on, Brett. Cool
it. I'm coming, dear. Wait a minute, dear.
Writing a story of her life there. Put it in the slot there. Okay.
Got it.
Brian Flanagan. Lawrence Welk said, wonderful, wonderful. Tonight on the show, we have King Kong. Mr. Kong will blank the Lennon sisters.
Well, since the Lennon sisters are singers, he's going to sing with the Lennon sisters.
He will sing the Lennon sisters.
With the Lennon sisters.
Oh, sing with the Lennon sisters. Yeah. Make you feel good, don't they?
Beautiful, beautiful.
All right, Clifton. He said they will sing with the Lennon sisters. What's that?
They added a with.
Yes, he said Mr. Kong will sing with the Lennon sisters. Okay, he added that word.
King Kong, like girl, take big girl, swing. Put
swing
W and
with,
sing.
Swing with the Lennon
swing
sisters.
With, yes.
Okay. All right, there's one idea.
No, that's not bad.
Brett?
I feel terrible about betraying a bartender. I have a certain strong feeling of loyalty to them. But I said he would claw and generally dissemble them.
Yeah. Brett, I've got to say something to you.
What, dear?
I'm sorry I asked.
Oh.
Yes.
I'm sorry. Steal or carry off?
Steal or carry off? Well, that's what he did with Faye Ray, wasn't it? He stole her or carried her off?
He stole her.
He stole her, yes. He stole her. Right. Took her right up to the top of the Empire State Building. Hello, Rona. Now...
I get so excited with these answers, I forgot what I wrote.
Tonight on the show, we have King Kong. Mr. Kong will blank the Lennon sisters. What do you say?
Well, maybe he should have kissed them, and maybe he should have something else. But anyway, he carried them off?
He carried them off, the Lennon sisters. Okay. Now, Richard, we are up to you.
What a way you have with words. Well, I was going to say carry them off.
You carried them off?
No.
You didn't.
He kissed them.
He kissed them.
All at the same time.
Oh, yeah, well, of course, yes, he could. Yeah. Oh, boy.
He's the only singing gorilla in town.
That's right. They loved it, I hear. What do you say?
No, I said he would give a lift to the Lennon sisters.
Give a lift to...
All the way up the Empire State Building.
Keep singing, ladies.
Give him a big hand.
Right, give him a big hand. So at the end of round one, it's 2-0 in favor of Barbara, and round two follows round one. Isn't that terrific? Shall we carry on? Round two coming up. Here we go. Now, let's see. The score is 2-0 in your favor. So since you're in the lead, you will go. Barbara, make your selection, A or B.
I'll stick with B.
B it is. Here we go again. Two people do not play. Brett and Betty do not play. The Admiral spends hours in the bathtub playing with his blank.
Barbara has a wonderful answer. She's applauding herself.
But this was yesterday.
The Admiral spends hours in the bathtub playing with his blank.
I have a wonderful answer, and I know it would match Barbara. I'm sorry I matched you before, Barbara. Because I could have matched you this time, too. Or also.
You're not playing yet.
I'm not playing.
Yeah.
Because we're smart.
Okay. Everybody, Charles, he's got an answer, so I'll slowly scroll over here to Barbara Benner. While Charles is finishing up writing there. And put it in the slot there. Here we go, Barbara. Are you ready? Here it is. The Admiral spends hours in the bathtub playing with his blank.
Rubber duck.
Rubber duck. Okay.
That's what I have.
Rubber duck. That's a traditional bathtub toy, isn't it, Clifton?
Yes. Yes, it is. And I thought that, but since you told us it was an admiral,
yeah.
I thought he was in the tub playing with his ships.
That's right. He could have a little warship in there. There's one possibility, Charles.
Because it was an admiral, I said little boatsy-boo.
Little boatsy-boo. Okay. No rubber ducks yet, Barbara. What do you offer?
I was going to offer a little rubber boat.
A rubber boat?
But I just wrote a boat.
A boat. We are looking for a rubber duck, Richard.
Wrote a boat?
Boat.
You wrote a boat.
I wrote a boat.
A rubber duck. Okay. One rubber duck. All right, Brian Flanagan, here's yours. You got to go, let's see now, 3-4 You're ready, Brian. Listen carefully now. It's a long one.
Oh,
a lot of words
long.
On the card. Now listen carefully. The circus ringmaster said, today's performance went perfect except for Hugo the human cannonball. Now, normally the cannon goes off and Hugo flies across the ring. Today, the cannon misfired and Hugo's blank flew across the ring.
Did they hit anybody?
I don't know.
Did we get another chapter of this tonight before we go home?
Could you
read this the whole thing?
Verse again.
This whole thing. The circus ringmaster said today's performance went perfect except for Hugo, the human cannonball. Normally the cannon goes off and Hugo flies across the ring. Today, however, the cannon misfired and Hugo's blank flew across the ring.
Poor devil. Hi, hon.
Hello there.
Did you make the reservations in Encino?
Shh.
Helen, that's just kidding.
You bet. Okay.
I have my answer.
All right, that's a good one. Put it in the slot there.
Do you have
Rona's ready?
Yes.
How old is Hugo?
Hugo, he was in his early 30s. All right, everybody
wait
ready over
minute.
Here?
I may have to change my answer.
No, wait a minute. Right, here we go. Brian Flanagan. The circus ringmaster said, today's performance went perfect except for Hugo, the human cannonball. Normally, the cannon goes off and Hugo flies across the ring. Have you ever seen that?
No, I never have.
No? Have you ever heard of it?
Oh, yes, many
times.
You've
seen pictures of this. Anyway, he says, today the cannon misfired and Hugo's blank flew across the ring.
Hairpiece.
Hairpiece. That's not a bad answer. All right. Shot his hairpiece right across the whole circus ring there. Let's see. Clifton, what do you say?
Well, I thought about helmet, but yeah. I thought it'd be more interesting if he had to pants fly off and he wore the cannon all the way home.
Right. There's one, Brett.
Are you married, Brian?
No, I'm not.
Would you like my phone number?
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Bottoms up.
Did you say that?
Can we say no? What do you mean?
Okay, would you like her phone number?
If she says hairpiece, I'd love it.
What condition?
Wait a minute now, hold on.
Well, she's already.
Her number is 7.
She may say hairpiece.
Give her a call.
Everybody's going to say hairpiece.
Come on now, show us your answer. Phone.
Well, just for that, I may not. I said rug.
Or hairpiece. Okay. That's Crestview 7645392187727. Charles.
Oh, how quickly you forget.
Yes.
It's a laundry, and they'll call her down to the phone.
Show and tell, Charles.
This is not a rug or a hairpiece.
What is it?
A toupee.
All right, score 3-2. Now, we need one more toupee or hairpiece to achieve a tie. Rhona, may we see it?
Why is it that Clifton and I agree on everything?
Trunks or tights, okay.
Would you
score
like
names,
my
3-2?
Phone number, Rhona?
No.
I'd love your phone
cool
number.
Cool it. Is it not the kind of a show? Richard, you're up.
Pardon?
Richard, show.
Isn't it about time the house bought a drink?
No. You're in a cheap
bar. The old
bar.
Thing went off.
Yes.
Hugo usually departed to cross ring into right. The net, right?
Right, exactly.
Well, this time his pantyhose went across.
His pantyhose. Okay.
He's bereft.
Now, Brian, to stay in the game, you've got to match Betty. What do you say, Betty?
Usually Hugo flew across the ring.
Right, exactly.
This time, it's no match. His wife, Bruce, flew across the ring.
Stand by for a moment here now while I talk to Brian. It was a pleasure meeting you, Brian. We've got some gifts for you, together with our best wishes. Brian Flanagan, ladies and gentlemen. Now, while he's spinning off, we're going to spin these messages for you. Then you hurry back. With Barbara Benner. This is her first time up here. Now, it's for the big time for the Big Money Super Match now, Barbara.
Okay.
Where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you. And I want to point out to you that you'll have a chance to multiply by 10, whatever amount of money you win here. All right? Here we go with the first one. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. The greatest blank. The answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 if it matches, $250, and $100. Whom do you call on for some help?
Richard.
The greatest show on earth.
The greatest show on earth is one.
Clifton,
have you got one?
Richard took the best answer, the greatest story ever told.
The greatest story ever told. Number two.
Brett,
you're in the third slot, the difficult position, but I know you, with your quick wit and mind, you will come up with a good one.
She won't get out of it. Go ahead, dear.
Will.
What is the third one?
Come on.
No, there's nothing here.
The greatest gift.
The greatest gift. So those are the three, the greatest gift, the greatest story ever told, and the greatest show on earth.
The greatest show on earth.
That's the one she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom as usual and reveal, if you would please, the $100 response. The greatest of ease. That's from that old song. We're the greatest of ease, a daring young man in the flying trees. Okay, cut. Thank you. We'll call you. Don't call us. Greatest show on earth is what we're looking for. $250 response will now be revealed. The greatest story ever told is the answer that Clifton gave. That's right. The Watergate tapes. Last chance for the greatest show on earth. Here's the $500 response. Greatest show on earth. Okay.
And in love. One back.
Now, Barbara, you've won $500, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now we're going to find out how much more you can win with our second audience match. All right, Earl, slide it. Woody Blank.
Okay,
let's find out who's going to help you here.
Okay, Betty. Woody Allen.
Woody Allen is one.
Richard.
Woody Woodpecker.
Woody Woodpecker is two. Clifton.
Both of those are so terrific. Woody Herman.
Woody Herman.
If you're into jazz music.
Yep, great.
Very good.
The great swing band player, Woody Herman, Woody Woodpecker, and Woody Allen. You want one of those?
Mm-hmm. Woody Allen.
You want Woody Allen?
Oh, Woody.
All right, that's the one we're looking for. Let's find
Woody
out
Woodpecker.
If Woody Allen is hiding under the $100 response.
Ta-da.
Woody Woodbury.
Oh.
Hmm. I don't
May
know
I
about
ask
that.
Who Woody Woodbury
All right,
is?
We're looking for Woody Allen. Here's a $250 number. Woody Woodpecker.
Yeah.
Well, that may be a good sign. That's the one that Richard gave you. Mm-hmm. Here's the last chance for Woody Allen. May we see the $500 response?
Yeah!
Got it. Okay, now, Barbara,
that's great.
You've won an additional $500 and punctured my eardrum. We multiply the $500 by 10, and that makes $5,000. Add that to the $5,000 you won previously. Gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. Now, to collect, you got to match one celebrity head-to-head exactly. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay. Richard, you get ready to write. You stand on the tape and face me. There's a hunk of tape there on that rug there. Here it is. For $10,000, permanent blank. No, you can't look at him.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. You just stay facing me here. Permanent blank. Now he's finished, Barbara. We ask for your answer, which you think will match his. What do you do here?
Permanent wave.
Permanent wave. All right, Richard. She says permanent wave will match you for $10,000. May we see your answer?
Yeah, that was years ago.
Permanent wave?
Yeah, I was just thinking of all the new clothing.
Oh, permanent press you were thinking of.
Just wave.
This little lady just won $11,000, and she's as happy as we are. See you next week on Match Game PMG Radio. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive from Fetters the rotary power pickup, a powerful room air conditioner, a lightweight you want to take it everywhere you go. And from Dexter...